สวัสดีครับ What's up guys Welcome back to another action figure review This episode is about the Cyborg Not the but just Cyborg you know? DC Cyborg 1/9 scale model Justice League Fawn Joy It's a Chinese licensed product Official product Fawn Joy is some kind of a brother of Song Dong toy or CD toy, you know, the one that made a lot of good Iron Man, good quality Iron Man armor figure. Yeah, this is the top gold, this is the bottom gold. Let's go and crack this thing open.Yeah. So we start off here. Brand new, of course. Let's see what's inside. Usually they open right here, right? Okay. Wow.That's a quite heavy one. Now, we see the Cyborg. Cyborg, not the, okay. But, you know, I'm just make a little mistake today. So, the behind is the stand. And then, there is nothing there behind.The box. So, the box looks like premium quality product, you know, but the price point is really, really cool. $20 or something, you know, less than $20 maybe. $20. And here we have the stand. I really like how the standworks, you know, you can see my face right there. Yeah, I like circle, you know, circle stuff makes it looks like more technology, you know, tech. It's like a tech graphic. And here just so let's see the articulation of the base, so we have some kind of C clamp here. And come on. Can we rotate this? I don't really see it. I'm not sure, you know. I don't want to break my stand, but it looks like too stiff or something. Yeah.It doesn't really easy to move. It's not easy to move. Okay, I'm just gonna leave it like that. So let's see the Cyborg himself. Oh, DC 103 something. We have the plastic cover over here, which is reveal the Cyborg here. So.We have interchangeable hands, open hand, just like so, and a hinge, interchangeable hand with hinge, and interchangeable hand with a gun, the arm gun. So I really like the texture here.Some texture looks shiny, glossy. Some texture look matte. I don't know why they paint like that, but yeah, at least it looks metally, metal-ish stuff. At least I really like the way that they include the interchangeable head here. So this one.Is really, really cyborg-ish. look at the eye. I wish we can have some kind of more paint in the brighter red color, so we can see it looks like growing in the dark or something, you know, just like a light up feature. So yeah, the cyborg himself, so we can stand him right away from the plastic tray. And the plastic tray doesn't have anything more. So we unbox all of that. Boom! Let's see his portrait, how he looks. Wow! Fonjoy nailed it. I mean, this is really realistic feeling, you know. Except the hair. I think the hair look in a cartoony side. Yeah, the eye also. The eyebrow look like a little bit of cartoony side, okay? But the rest is realistic, and the likeness of Cyborg himself, aka Ray Fisher, is there. The likeness is there. Likeness is there. I don't think the hair should be, you know, all over the metal part. The metal area should be cover the hair, I think. Maybe they paint something a little bit wrong, I'm not sure. But this side is really, really cool. I really like the robotic cyborg side. And this one is a human side. And yeah, for the price point, you get two pairs of hands and one for the weapon hand, aka five hands, and two interchangeable heads, which is a pretty good value for the price point. And the paint job is not, it's not bad. I mean, it's there, you know, it's a real cyborg there. Cyborg each painting, you can see that. Yeah, he had what it takes to be realistic cyborg movie, you know. And I don't like the way they paint the red color for, you know, replicate the light up feature. Cyborg has a light in his chest, you know, in the movie, Justice League 2 version. I don't think the first version is not that bad, and the Snyder Cut is also a little bit better, I think. I think the story is still, I don't know, still almost the same. Yeah, some part is not the same. Yeah, I don't know why Superman transform red and blue color to black without no reason, you know. So talking about that movie, and here is a cyborg. Wow, he has, you know, crazy detail. I really like this kind of character, you know, because the character like this has a lot of detail, and the detail looks super, super cool, you know. It's like they put a lot of effort to make the texture like this. So let's check out his articulation. Head can turn side to side. A lot of head tilt, which is awesome. Personality pose. What? You got a problem? What? Something like that. And so he can look up. I mean, look down. Looking down that far. And looking up for the flying character, he can look up. Oh, I pop his head off. Come on, back again. Okay, so and for your flying character, he can look up that far. Yeah, we can make some fly pose, sure. but not extremely far, you know what I mean? Just just a little far for the flying pose. Let's do a T pose. He has a shoulder pad which has which they both have shoulder pad that have both joint, and we can some kind of move up, move down a little bit for help the pose, you know. Actually it pop up, there is a ball joint here for the shoulder pad. Actually it can move up and move down. Yeah, that's cool. Okay, yeah, we can do a T pose, actually more than T pose, but we have to pop up the shoulder pad, which I don't do that. So he can do T pose. He can do the ab crunch, and this one is a diaphragm joint. So side to side and waist swivel. So side to side, and here both joints pivot to the left, to the right, and yeah, leaning back is a lot. I really like it. Leaning back and forward. How much he can do forward? I wish we have more than that, you know. He doesn't really have forward that much, but he has some. And here is, so can we have some kind of a butterfly joint? So it's not butterfly, it's like a socket that we can shift on, off, and in, out, in, out. Okay, that's how we can do that. In, out, for help shoulder rotation, biceps swivel. Look at the joy. I really like the joy. Double joy, you know. I prefer double joy. It's like a Mafex style. Yeah, this one reminds me a lot of Mafex style. But Mafex is 1/12 scale, you know. This one is 1/9 scale. So double jointed elbow. Yeah, he can do more than that. And double joy. I really like the joint. The joint looks seamless and blend to the body. And here is a wrist, turn side to side and hinge up and down. And really easy to adjust. It's way more easy than the ball joint that you can rotate to any direction. It's a tricky, but this one is straight up, straight away. So it's easy to pose and manage more. Okay, now we have a drop down hinge for the leg. Yeah, you can see that it's right there, drop down hinge. And so let's see, he can do split. I don't think he can do that much. He can do, yeah, he can do some. Not easy to make him split, you know. Yeah, he's not gymnastic character, by the way. But yeah, he can split that far, which is not, I don't think it's enough. I wish we have more than that, because McFarlane can do it. Anyway, drop down, leg split, and so we looking for to see the kick forward right there, and kick back. So it's not easy to rotate. It's a new figure. It's stiff kick back, and okay, upper thigh cut. So absolutely upper thigh cut, but we have this speed to get in the way. Upper thigh cut, double joy at knee, which is really nice, double joy. double joint make more range of motion. Oh, we have a double joint in including double joint rotation right here. So the upper can rotate, and I think the lower can rotate. Not really. Yeah, but the upper can rotate. That's a new thing, you know. Usually we don't see this kind of system. Yeah, look at this side. So he can still rotate in this side. Of course, they are leg, you know. They should be the same system. You shouldn't force that much, you know. Sometimes the leg gets stuck by its design, by his design. So, and ankle, let's see, ankle move down, ankle move up, just a little bit, and ankle pivot. Awesome. Oh, it's not really ankle pivot. It's a ball joint at the ankle. And yeah, we can do pivot some, but not a lot. At least he has. So, and toe joint right here. Awesome. I really like the figure that include toe joint. But the thing is, he is 1/9 scale. Actually, he is close to 1/10 scale, you know. The McFarlane figure and Fontjoy figure doesn't they don't have the likeness that close to the actor. I mean, some of the character likeness is not right there, you know what I mean. So let's do our traditional pose for the channel, superhero landing pose. Can he do that? Yeah, of course he can do that for sure, right? Because he is the cyborg and he is similar to Iron Man character, you know. So before we go there, let's see if he is awesome with the interchangeable head. Yeah, okay, pretty good, really really cool. And here is the, we don't have fisted hand, which is I feel regret about it. Yeah, I wish we have fisted hand for punching, you know, punching people. And let's change his hand to the gun right here. Blast gun effect hand, and here, yeah. Cyborg, maybe we include the stand so he can do superhero landing on his stand with his name on it, and we remove all the interchangeable parts in here. So yeah, that's that. Cyborg in superhero landing pose, 360 rotation for you guys. Lovely. So it's about 20 minutes already. It's almost 20 minutes. Yeah. Let's see you guys on the next episode. Bye.